Hi guys, this is Ken Yuzinski from CatholicSpeaker.com. Today, let's talk about the Holy Spirit and Pentecost. Back in 1999, I was hired by 6 different Catholic churches to start and run a senior youth program. They didn't have anything, so I was hired. And before I was accepted the position, I shared with them that it was going to be about evangelization, bringing young people into a personal relationship with Jesus Christ. And so they were on board with that, so I was hired. And over the first 2 months, that's what I really focused on. I created these lessons, and we talked about that God has a purpose for our life, that purpose and plan has been messed up by sin, that He sent His Son, Jesus Christ, to redeem humanity and welcome us back into a relationship with Him, that He gave us the church to live out this relationship, and we live it out by the power of grace coming to us through the sacraments. And I really emphasized the decision. I challenged the young people in asking them, have you placed Jesus at the center of your life? And so these themes were throughout the 2 months. And to tell you the truth, I never saw any substantial change in their life. You know, they kept on coming out. I'm not sure why. Maybe they liked me, or they liked hanging out with their friends. They came, but there was no change of lifestyle. And the reason I know is because they would tell me what they were doing on the weekends, which wasn't always very good. And so I was getting a little bit frustrated with this. So we moved on to the next lesson. And the next chunk of our lessons was on the Holy Spirit. And we focused a lot on that upper room experience where the apostles were there and they heard the sound of a violent rushing wind and tongues of fire descended upon them, and they all began to speak in other languages and the Holy Spirit enabled them, and then they went out into the streets. And we made the point that the apostles' lives were dramatically changed by the power of the Holy Spirit. Take, for example, Peter. He went from a scaredy cat to a roaring lion. He was in the courtyard on the day Jesus was crucified, denying that he even was an associate of Jesus. And the next, after Pentecost, he is standing on the streets roaring, proclaiming Jesus is Lord and saying, repent and be baptized if you want to be saved. There was a dramatic change in the lives of the apostles. No question to them, they had received the promise of the Father, the Holy Spirit. And so I challenged the young people and asked them, have you ever consciously surrendered yourself to the power of the Holy Spirit? Pope Benedict XVI said, today I would like to extend this invitation to everyone. Let us rediscover, dear brothers and sisters, the beauty of being baptized in the Holy Spirit. Let us be aware again of our baptism and of our confirmation, sources of grace that are always present. So in our youth group, we'd made the point that we have the Holy Spirit, but have we asked for the release, for the power of the Spirit in our life? Have we asked to be baptized in the Holy Spirit? So after emphasizing these points for a number of weeks, I invited the young people to go before and to stand before the tabernacle in a semicircle. And in the middle of the semicircle, I placed a chair. And I invited them and said, if there's anyone here that would like to ask for the fuller release of the Holy Spirit in their life, just sit in that chair and we'll pray for you. And one by one, these young people started to take turns sitting in that chair. We'd come up around that person, we'd put our hands towards them, and we would pray for them in simple language, asking for the Holy Spirit to be released more fully in their life. And those evenings when we did that in those parishes, I mean, it was powerful. Those young people experienced the love of God being poured into their hearts. And if you speak to them now, many of them would say that those evenings were defining moments in their life where their faith became alive. After this experience, every youth night, we would give opportunities for young people to receive prayer. And we did this for years. And it was such a faith-building experience for them. They continuously would come before the Lord asking for the Spirit to help them in their relationship with their parents, decision-making, just living the virtuous life. And it was a beautiful time of an outpouring of the Spirit in their lives, including my own. I remember one night that chair was empty and no one was going to sit in it. And so I said, hey, could you pray for me? And so I sat in that chair. And the young people just came around me and they just started to pray for me. And I remember one young man taking the lead. He's maybe grade 8. And his prayer was so simple. All he said was, Holy Spirit, come now. Holy Spirit, come now. And he just kept on saying that prayer over and over and over again. And I experienced that night a tremendous healing in my heart. Just felt the love of God just being released in my life in a brand new way. Now, my experience was beautiful. The young people's experiences over those years was beautiful. And really what the theme was that we were encountering the love of God. So my friends, my question for you is this. Have you asked for the release of the Spirit in your life? Have you gone to the Holy Spirit and said, Holy Spirit, fill me with the grace that the apostles experienced in that upper room. Baptize me in the Holy Spirit. Release the fullness of the Spirit within my life. Have you ever gone to the Holy Spirit asking for that? Because the thing is, this doesn't happen automatically. This doesn't happen accidentally. It only happens when we intentionally go to the Holy Spirit in faith and say, do with me whatever you want. You see, the Holy Spirit in Acts chapter 2 was found by seekers. He was found by the apostles. The apostles were seeking the Lord, seeking to remain faithful to Jesus' words, to remain and wait for the promise of the Father, the Holy Spirit. So my friends, I welcome you to ask for the presence of Pentecost to be more fully released in your life. You might be thinking, well, how do I do that? Well, just close your eyes, open up your hands and say, come Holy Spirit, come Holy Spirit, come Holy Spirit.